Hello friends, chapter number 7, alternating current. Now we know that there are mainly two types of signals, AC signal and DC signal. In DC signal, voltage or current remain constant with respect to time, but in AC signal, voltage or current varies like a sine function, right? We already know this concept. In DC signal, voltage or current remain constant, where in AC, voltage or current change with time t or varies like a sine function. But most of the power companies are transfer and distribute the alternating current. So we prefer the AC signal as compared to DC signal. And another advantage of AC signal is we convert the voltage by using the transformers, right? So this is the discussion about AC signal and DC signal. Again friends, in DC signal, voltage or current remain constant with respect to time, where in AC signal, voltage or current change with the time, or we can say varies like a sine function. But most of power transfer companies are distribute alternating current, so we prefer AC signal, right? Now friends, first we discuss the AC voltage applied to resistor. The question will be like this: explain AC voltage applied to resistor. So here in this theory we derive equation of current, then power, then RMS value of voltage, current, and then average power, right? So first of all friends, here we connect AC source to a resistor, right? So as shown in figure, the AC source is connected to the resistor, and we know that the equation of voltage, we already discussed this concept in chapter 6, V is equal to Vm sin omega E, right? Instead of E, here we use voltage V. So we know that voltage V is equals to Vm sin omega T, right? So here we have to derive the equation of current. So again friends, V is equals to Im, right? But V is equals to Im. So here instead of V, IR is equals to Vm sin omega t. Here we have to derive equation of current. So I is equals to Vm by R sin omega t. But Vm by R is equals to Im, maximum value of current, right? So the equation of current is I is equals to Im sin omega t. So here see, equation 1, V is equals to Vm sin omega t, and equation of current I is equals to Im sin omega t. So here from this equation we can say that here voltage and current are in same phase. See, sin omega t is there. So here from 1 and 2 we say that voltage and current are in same phase. So again friends, when we apply AC voltage to resistors as shown in figure. AC source is connected to resistor R. So we already know the equation of voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Now to derive the equation of current, we know that V is equal to IR. So instead of V, IR is equal to Vm sin omega t. So I is equal to Vm by R sin omega t. But Vm by R is equal to Im. So I is equal to Im sin omega t. So here friends, from 1 and 2, see the equation of voltage Vm sin omega t. See the equation of current Im sin omega t. So here we can say that the voltage and current are in same phase. Right? Now, we derive equation of average power. So now, average power. The question will be like this. Derive equation of average power when AC voltage applied to resistor. Now, we already know that power P is equal to I square R. We know that power P is equal to I square R, right? But here current I is equal to Im sin omega t, right? So but current I is equal to Im sin omega t. So the power will be like this, power P is equal to, instead of I, Im sin omega t whole square into R. So the equation will be like this, power P is equal to Im square sin square omega t into R, right? So the equation will be like this, P is equal to Im square into R sin square omega t. This is equation 3, right? So the equation of power P is equal to Im square into R sin square omega t. But here we have to find out average power. So here we have to take average of this equation 3. So the average value of power P, that is average P, is equal to average value of Im square R sin square omega t. Right? So here Im square and R value remains same. So P is equal to Im square into R into average value of sin square omega t. Now friends, you have to remember the average value of sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. Right? So here the average value of sin square omega t, say average sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. So the average power, average value of P is equal to Im square into R, and average value of sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. So average power P is equal to Im square into R divided by 2. Right? So the equation of average power is equal to Im square into R divided by 2. Right? So once again friends, we know that power P power P is equal to I square R, but we know that I is equal to Im sin omega t. So P is equal to, instead of I, Im sin omega t whole square into R. So Im square sin square omega t into R. So the equation of power will be like this, Im square R sin square omega t. We have to find out the average power. So here we take average of this equation number 3. So average power is equal to average value of Im square R sin square omega t. Right? But Im square into R same. So Im square into R into average value of sin square omega t. But average value of sin square omega t is 1 by 2. So average power is equals to Im square into R divided by 2. Right? Now we draw a waveform and phasor. Or we can say wave and phasor. The question will be like this: draw the waveforms and phasor when AC voltage applied to resistor. Now, see here, friends. Here we have to draw a wave of voltage and current, right? So now, a waveform of voltage and current. Now see, here the equation of V is equals to Vm sine omega t. So here voltage varies like a sine function, right? So the waveform of voltage is like this. So the waveform of voltage like this. This is 0. Pi by 2, then pi, 3 pi by 2, and here 2 pi. Right? So the waveform of voltage is like this. Now, waveform of current. Now see, the equation of current, I is equals to, here the equation of voltage, V is equals to Vm sine omega t. So here voltage varies like a sine function. Now see, the equation of current, I is equals to Im sine omega t. So here current varies like a sine function. But see, Im is equals to Vm by 2, Vm by R, right? So here Im is equals to Vm by R. So the magnitude of current is less as compared to voltage, because I is equals to Im sine omega t, where Im is equals to Vm by R, right? So the magnitude of current is less as compared to voltage. So the current is like this, right? So this dotted line is the waveform of current I, right? So we know that here the voltage and current are in same phase, right? So there is no phase difference between voltage and current, right? So this is the waveform of voltage and current, right? Here V is equals to Vm sine omega t. So voltage varies like a sine function. I is equals to Im sine omega t. So current varies like a sine function. But Im is equals to Vm by R. So the magnitude of current is less as compared to voltage. And here voltage and current are in same phase. So there is no phase difference between voltage and current, right? Now, we draw phasor. Now, what is phasor? So friends, remember, phasor is a vector rotating with angular speed omega. Right? See here, omega is there. Right? So phasor is a vector which is rotating with angular speed omega. Right? So phasor is a vector which is rotating with angular speed omega. Right? So here phasor is a vector which is rotating with angular speed omega. So here we draw a phasor is like this. Right? Now, here see. First of all, a phasor of voltage. So phasor is a simply vector. So here we draw a vector of voltage with an angle omega t. So here this is some angle omega t. So this is omega t. And this is the phasor of voltage. Right? Now, phasor.
फेजर ऑफ करंट सो I इज इक्वल्स टू Im sin omega t हियर वोल्टेज एंड करंट आर इन सेम फेज सो नो फेज डिफरेंस राइट सो द फेज इज ओमेगा t बट I इज इक्वल्स टू Im sin omega t वेयर Im इज इक्वल्स टू Vm / R राइट सो द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इज लेस एज कंपेयर टू वोल्टेज सो हियर वोल्टेज एंड दिस इज करंट because here voltage and current are in same phase so this is the current I right so these are the phasor of voltage and current right so the question will be like this draw a phasor diagram when AC voltage applied to resistor so this is the phasor diagram when AC voltage applied to a resistor. Now friends, we discuss about RMS value of voltage and current. RMS value of voltage and current. Now what is RMS value? So RMS value is the root mean square value of any physical quantity, right? So what is RMS value? So RMS value is root mean square value of any physical quantity. So here we have to find the RMS value of voltage and current. So first of all, we find RMS value of voltage that is equals to VRMS. So as we discuss the definition, what is RMS value? So root mean square value, right? So here we have to find out the RMS value of voltage. So here we take root mean square. So first of all, we take the square of voltage. So this is like V square. Then we have to take the mean value. So this is the mean and we have to take root of it. So this is the equation of RMS value of voltage. VRMS is equal to square root of RMS of V square. Right? So to find out the RMS value, again friends, see. Here we have to find out the RMS value of voltage. So here we have to take the square of voltage. Then we have to take the mean value. So this is like this mean value. And then we have to take the square root. Right? So first of all we have to take square of voltage. Then mean and at last root. Right? So what is RMS? So root mean square value of physical quantity that is known as RMS. Right? Now to find out the RMS value of voltage, see VRMS is equal to square root of mean of V square. So square root of mean value of V. We know that see here V is equal to Vm sin omega t. So V square is equal to Vm square sin square omega t, right? So here V square is equal to Vm square sin square omega t, right? From equation 1, right? So VRMS is equal to square root of mean value of V square. So square root of mean value of V square that is equal to Vm square sin square omega t. But we already know that mean value of sin square omega t, here the average value, right? Then average value of, or here we have to take this, not average, this is mean value, right? So we know that mean value of sin square omega t, this mean value of sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. So here the mean value of sin square omega t is equals to 1 by 2. So Vrms is equals to square root of Vm square into mean value of sin square omega t. Right, but mean value of sin square omega t is equals to 1 by 2. So Vm square by 2. Right? So here we take the square root of it. So Vrms is equals to Vm by root 2. Right? So the equation of Vrms is equals to Vm by root 2. Same. The RMS value of current, IRMS, is equals to Im by root 2, right? Because see, the equation of current, I is equals to Im sin omega. So here, square root of mean value of Im square sin square omega t, mean value of sin square omega t 1 by 2. So IRMS is equals to Im by root 2, right? So this is the equation of RMS value of voltage and current, right? So once again, to find out the RMS value, we have to take square of voltage, then mean, and at last root. So square root of average value or mean value of V square, that is equal to Vm square sin square omega t. But the mean or average value of sin square omega t is equals to 1 by 2. So square root of Vm square by 2. So Vrms is equals to Vm by root 2. Same, you can derive Irms is equals to Im by root 2. Right? So the question will be like this. Prove the equation of RMS value of voltage and current. So Vrms is equals to Vm by root 2. And Irms is equals to Im by root 2, right? Now, here, see, we derive the equation of average power, Im square by 2 into R, right? So here, if we take the square of this equation, so Irms square is equals to Im square by 2, right? So this equation also we can write like this, is equals to Im square by 2. So Im square by 2 is equal to Irms square. So Irms square into R. Right? So the equation of average power is like this, Irms square into R. Because this Im square by 2, this Im square by 2 is equal to Irms square. So Irms square into R is equal to average power, right? So this is the equation of the average power is equal to Im square R by 2 is equal to I square Rms into R, right? Now we discuss some examples based on this concept. See, example number 1. Hundred-ohm resistor is connected to a 220 volt and 50 hertz AC supply. So here resistance is given, that is capital R, 100 ohm, is connected to 220 volt supply. So here Vrms is equals to 220 volt having frequency 50 hertz. So F 50 hertz. What is the RMS value of current in the circuit? So here we have to find out the RMS value of current, right? So we know that V is equals to IR. So we can say Vrms is equals to Irms into R, right? V is equals to IR. So Vrms is equals to Irms into R. So
IRMS is equals to VRMS divided by R. So value of VRMS 220 divided by 100. So IRMS is equals to 2.2 ampere. Right. So here the RMS value of current is equals to 2.2 ampere. Now B, what is the net power consumed over a full cycle? Right. So here we have to find out the power P, and we know that power P is equals to V square by R, right? So V square RMS by R. So 220 whole square divided by 100, right?
So the power is 484.
So 484 watt, right? So here the power P is equals to V square by R. So V square RMS divided by R. So 220 whole square divided by 100. Now see example number 2.
The peak voltage of an AC supply is 300 watt.
Peak, that is VM. So here peak voltage is given, that is equals to 300 watt.
So what is the RMS voltage?
So here we have to find out VRMS. So we already know the formula. VRMS is equals to VM by root 2. Right. So VRMS is equals to VM by root 2. So 300 divided by 1.41.
Right. So you will get VRMS 212.2.
So 212.2 watt. Right. So the value of RMS value of voltage VRMS is equals to VM by root 2. So we get 212.2 watt.
Now second, the RMS value of current in an AC circuit is 10 ampere.
So here in second case, RMS value of current is given, that is equals to 10 ampere. So we have to find out the peak value of current. So here we have to find out the peak value of current, that is equals to Im. So again friends, we know that IRMS is equals to Im by root 2. So Im is equals to root 2 into IRMS, right? Because IRMS is equals to Im by root 2. So Im is equals to root 2 into IRMS. So 1.41 into IRMS, that is equals to 10. So we get peak value of current 14.1 ampere, right?
So the peak value of current is equals to Im is equals to root 2 into IRMS. So we get 14.1 ampere. Okay friends, thank you.